Everybody please rise. We're going to stand for the presentation of our colors. We're going to ask that all of our guests and our scholars please remain standing for the presentation of our colors. Then we're going to say the Pledge of Allegiance and hear our national anthem at this time. Presentation of our colors. Thank you. attendance, and I want to thank Richards High School, NJROTC organization, and alumni from the middle school here today for getting this started. Richards High School does an amazing job preparing scholars to leave here, and it's nice to see them coming back for the presentation of colors today. We also want to thank our concert band for the national anthem, and never easy to come up to the mic. We had three eighth grade ambassadors, Leah, Cyrus, and Adrian, coming up to the podium to pledge allegiance. Also one of the things that brings us all together today. So we greatly appreciate everyone's time as you joined us today for our Veterans Day Assembly. My name is Sean McNichols. I am the principal, very proud and grateful principal here at Oklahoma Hometown Middle School, part of this incredible district, the 123 family. I think I have to begin with, recently we were recognized as an exemplary school. Sounds fantastic. Outstanding educators and the partnerships that we have with our families and our local community that bring a celebration of exemplary status to our middle school. But I believe it's days like today that exemplify more than any assessment or any results that we have as to why our school is so extraordinary. So thank you for joining us as we honor the brave men and women who have served our nation's armed forces. Today, we gather to express our deep gratitude for the dedication, their courage and sacrifices they have made for each one of us to be able to sit here in our gym and gather together. Veterans Day is a time to celebrate those who have represented our country with honor. We are truly privileged to share this day and our space with all of you today. We can't thank you for taking the time enough to be here with us. We know that in sharing this space with you, we get a small opportunity to say thank you and celebrate the extraordinary people and individuals that you truly are. So I want to say thanks to everyone for being here and taking the time. Our veterans have made a remarkable commitment. They have set a course for themselves over the course of their lives to put themselves second and put our country and every one of us sitting here first. They've given us one of the most valuable resources that any one of us can ever provide, and that's the gift of time. They've dedicated their lives, in some cases their entire careers, to us, to our safety, to our freedom, in a way of life that we all appreciate. Time is precious and it's finite, and our veterans understand that better than most. They've shown us what it means to use that time in a meaningful way and absolutely use that in a selfless manner. So today I'm especially proud. I get to stand up in front of everybody, and much like the morning announcements, today is you get to meet my dad, Tim, who's a Navy veteran sitting over here. My father, who wants to go. Also have my father-in-law Joe, who's here today, who is an Army veteran, and my mother-in-law Linda. So I really appreciate them being here. Our scholars are sitting and doing an awesome job being patient as we're going to speak through a bunch of different people and hear some stories. One of the things that I think we sometimes forget as young people is time. And it is not often that you will have an opportunity opportunity, much like I am privileged to have in this moment, to have my father, my father-in-law, and my mother-in-law sitting with me just to say thank you. Scholars, take an opportunity when you get home, or if your grandma, your grandpa, your parent are here, to thank them. Time is not definite. It is something that eventually will go away. Again, the people that are sitting here understand that thought. So take a moment when you get home today, this afternoon, this weekend, to really thank your families. Thank your mom and dad. They've given you the opportunities that you have, that we have, and all they want for you is to be better and more. So take advantage of that time. So I want to say thank you very much. Each year, this tribute brings me the greatest sense of pride for our school, for our staff, for our scholars, and our community and one another. We take a moment to pause and recognize the sacrifices made by our veterans. Our veterans remind us that time is precious. Our veterans remind us that they can show us that they can make a difference, that we can make a difference, that each one of us has the freedom to choose, and it's because of each of the veterans that we're given that opportunity. So they defend what is right, and they cherish the freedoms that we get to enjoy on a daily basis. Their dedication shows us that every minute we can have a profound effect. To our scholars, as I mentioned, remember how important time is. Remember to be appreciative and thank those around you that love you the most and will always be there for you. Remember that you have the gift of time on your side. You're at a stage in your life where time holds endless possibilities. Take the opportunity to learn, to grow, and to make great choices that will shape your future. Yes, we're excited too. And I hope you'll be inspired by our veterans here today to use the time to make a positive impact on the world. To our passionate staff, thank you for educating another generation of citizens who will one day stand in the footsteps of the brave people we have the honor to share our time with this morning. To our volunteers, musicians, and everyone who helped create this tribute, thank you for making this such a memorable one for all of us. And to our veterans, thank you for showing us what it means to be a hero. Your legacy truly inspires all of us. And at this time, I'll ask if able, our veterans could please stand. And allow us to honor you with a round of applause. This day is about you. Can you please stand with us? At the middle school, another thing we hear every day is we strive to be a dynamic environment that ignites lifelong learners, embraces diversity, and contributes positively to our community and global society. We know we are preparing today's learners for tomorrow's world and creating those dreams to become a reality. We greatly appreciate your sacrifices for our families and allow us the opportunity to learn for tomorrow. Thank you for your time, thank you for your bravery, and most importantly, thank you for your service.
Some have lived while others have died, but all of them deserve our pride. We're proud of all the soldiers who kept thinking of red, white, and blue. They fought for us and all of our rights. They fought through many days of battles. And those though we may not know each name, we thank all veterans just the same.
No.
My name is Fabian Sotelo, and I'm here to talk about my hero, also known as my father, Jose Sotelo. He is my hero for many reasons. The one that stands out to me most is that he enlisted in the U.S. Army at the age of 19 and deployed on his birthday to fight for America's freedom. He helped protect our freedom as he was stationed in Iraq in 2006 and served in the Army for 18 years. Dad, words cannot thank you enough for what you did to keep this country free. Thank you for everything.
Thank you.
shocked sometimes when I listen to them that these are just middle school students. They are incredible. And I do have to say, between the chorus and the band, the students that are seated up here put so many hours and so much time into their craft. If we could give them another huge round of applause. So once again, thank you to each of them here, to the kind of reassembling. They have multiple parts. At this time, I'd like to welcome a guest who has led a service-focused career. United States Army 1st Infantry Division, retired Oklahoma Police Chief of Patrol, and current Mayor of Oklahoma, Mr. Terry Ford.
Price that they paid for their freedom, and that's what these men and women have done for us. So thank you. Thank you again for what you do for your students. And of course, it's important for me to recognize our dignitaries here today. We have Congressman Sean Caston. Congratulations on your election. Generations from the American Revolution to Civil War,
World War I and World War II. Without those veterans, we might be speaking a different language here in America. Vietnam, and all the wars in the Middle East. You fought for democracy. You fought to share that democracy and that right with the rest of the world. Whether we won or lost, we should be honorable men and women just to have done that. Now, students, once again, I want you to think about your career in the future. You're going to make a lot of decisions in your life, maybe with the help of your parents, what schools you might go to, what high schools, what college. But I want you to think about serving America and joining one of these branches. You will never regret it. You're going to work hard. You're going to give a little bit of your sweat, and you will make a commitment to America, to even to do the ultimate sacrifice. But you'll learn things that you can learn nowhere else in the world but in our military. Think about it. And after you serve this country, you will always be proud of it. You will sit maybe in this room in the future where we respect you and the people that have served this country. And I also want to mention that this country offers its veterans great benefits, which not only will make you proud, but can help you, whether it be tuition, health care, and hundreds of other things you will earn by getting a couple of years of your life to the United States of America. With that, I think I've spoken enough, and it's now my time to introduce some of our dignitaries that want to speak. We are honored again to have a U.S. Congressman here. A U.S. Congressman. You know how important that is here? Congressman Sean Caston, would you step up, please?
Thank you, Terry. It's an honor to be here. Thank you to all our veterans. I want to say one of the things that I think is always the most touching when I come to these events is when the majority of the people on the river are not veterans. And I say that because for us to understand and support our veterans, I always speak into a room full of veterans. I can do that at a VFW hall. But if we're not really honoring our veterans and supporting our veterans, we talk to them, share their stories. So we appreciate all of you. I hope everybody in the room, young and old, like, take some time to get to know and chat with them. I'm not a veteran myself. My grandfather was fought in the Army, fought in the Battle of Belgium in World War II. He's no longer with us. My dad was an engineering battalion in the Marine Corps. I think he was there and back a little bit before you were there, but was out there as well. Neither of them talked a lot about their service. Most veterans I know do not talk a lot about their service as civilians. And I think it's important to understand that. My own lens of this from now 6 years in Congress is, number one, that every year we provide the funding and strategy for our military, close to $800 billion a year, to make sure that we have the preeminent fighting force in the world, that we're capable of fighting wars on two fronts at the same time, and to make sure that we are always staying one step ahead of our adversaries who would like to outfox us and outsmart us. It's a privilege and an honor to select students to our military academies every year. But one of the things that you're sort of struck by, particularly as we deal with the constituent services on the back end, is how the process of making sure that we are always the world's preeminent army means that we are always planning for tomorrow's war. And because our veterans understandably are reluctant to share some of their experiences, the stereotype of what veterans go through is also often informed by yesterday's war. And so I want to, particularly for the younger people here, as you go through and you take your history, appreciate the fact that our military has always set out to have the absolute best, most well-trained, most competent, most resourced people that are there. As a result of that, the military, we integrated our military before we integrated our schools. The military has always a function of your grade, and so there's never been a gender pay gap that there has been in other fields. Those are good things, but think about what that means, that if you were fighting the greatest unit in World War II, and then you came home and your country didn't treat you with the same thing. That in many ways led to the civil rights era, but of course that was the stress that those veterans brought home that we didn't always appreciate. In the Vietnam era, the first real televised war, the first guerrilla war, this wasn't the kind of war we were used to fighting. We had soldiers who came home who were all of a sudden not respected by the American people because they had seen images on the television that they didn't support. People who were doing their duty, who were serving, but didn't feel thanked for their support. That created its own set of mental health challenges. In both Vietnam and in the Gulf War, for the first time, we had soldiers who were exposed to toxics that were deployed by the good guys. Whether that was Agent Orange in Vietnam or soldiers exposed to burn pits. And it's much harder for our country to reconcile with that. 2 years ago in Congress, we finally passed the PACT Act to acknowledge that suffering and to make sure that soldiers have the benefit of those needs. And just for context, there's 1,800 veterans just in the 6th District who have taken advantage of that benefit that wasn't there before. If the enemy had exposed them to those toxics, it wouldn't have been a problem. But we had a hard time grappling with that. You've now got folks, we talked to a lot of particularly younger soldiers who've been deployed through Afghanistan, where so much of those wars have been fought remotely with high-tech tools, which creates a whole sense of mental stress issues that are very different from being in the field. You're still exposed to war, but instead of coming home and being in a tent with your troop mates and people who have shared experiences, maybe you leave and you've got to go buy groceries on your way home. How do you process that, right? And the mental health challenges that we're still coming with. And we do our best to do that in Washington. We don't always do as good a job, but for those folks who have not served, number one, respect the veterans who maybe don't want to talk about it right now, but number two, when they do, appreciate that what they have done is the highest form of sacrifice, that they are bearing burdens that we will never understand, and to do our best to make sure that we honor their service. So thank you to all who have served, and to all your people, and everybody else for coming out and honoring them as well. Thank you.
Serving our great country with unwavering dedication,
yet facing the many challenges that come with it. Today, I want to focus on the importance of Veterans Day, not only from my perspective as a veteran, but also from the collective duty we as U.S. citizens share in honoring our veterans and ensuring the true meaning of this day is not forgotten. Today is a day for every citizen to remember and honor the sacrifice of our nation's veterans. It is important to celebrate the service of all our veterans, those who fought during the time of war, and those who fought to maintain the peace. We need to take a few moments to recognize the men and women who are serving in today's active duty military, guard, and reserve, who, as we meet, are doing everything they can to defend and preserve freedom and liberty. The sacrifices and accomplishments made by today's generation of patriots are many, and their dedication to our way of life and the values our country was founded upon serve as a reminder that tyranny and evil will never prevail. The lessons taught by what veterans have provided, all of us should never be forgotten.
It is up to each of us
to keep the legacy of our nation's veterans alive, to make sure the same spirit and faith in democracy carries through so that future generations will also celebrate the unity, courage, valor, and valor of purpose that is the strength of a free nation. Veterans Day holds a special place in my heart, as it does for all of you that have worn the uniform of our great nation. It is a day that reminds us of the commitment that we made to defend the principles of freedom, liberty, and justice. It is a day that we reflect on a time spent away from home, the bonds formed with our brothers in arms, and the sacrifice made on both our native foreign shores to protect the American way of life and those striving to safeguard the river.
We must work to
remind our nation that the Veterans Day isn't just a calendar. It is a reminder of not only the commitment and courage might need a new battery. Secondly, high cost of freedom who have selflessly sacrificed for us. As a veteran, I want to help ensure that the importance of Veterans Day is understood by all. And I encourage everyone here to engage in public conversations, participate in community events that make awareness for our military and veteran community. We was made mission to educate and remind future generations that at its core,
American spirit is defined by
resilience, selflessness, and commitment.
Today's
world is often hyper-focused on division,
and Veterans Day provides us an opportunity
to remember that despite different beliefs and lifestyles, our desire for a better life has always been united. Every veteran has proudly worn the uniform of our nation, has served alongside countless individuals from differing backgrounds who may even had opposing viewpoints or opinions, and yet all tied those differences to focus on the values of freedom and liberty that bring.
My brothers and sisters in arms here, veterans all around the world, I wish you a happy Veterans Day.
Your heartfelt thank you. Thank you all.
As if I wasn't sweaty enough, as Mike has to go in and out. I'm going to hope that it doesn't go out again in this moment, but I do want to thank all of our distinguished guests for taking the time today to celebrate this beautiful day, and also taking the time to speak through the microphone that sometimes doesn't want to cooperate. At this time, it's really important to thank each of our guests that came up here. Again, never easy to take the mic, especially when it's going in and out, but there is such a beautiful message that we continue to hear throughout every one of the speakers that are taking the podium today. So I want to thank each of them for coming up. Right now, we're going to invite a couple of middle school 8th grade scholars, Calvin and Evelyn, to the microphone. While I'm changing the batteries, these two amazing young people are waiting patiently. We are going to enjoy our concert band as they perform under the direction of Ms. Lyons and Mr. Duffy, our band directors.
George Futex, Harvey Michael Cole, James Narbucky, John DeVizio, John Holler, John Turner, Jose Sotelo, Joseph Grimes Jr., Joseph Costaldi, Joseph Rizzo, Luis Hashish, Paul Evans, Paul Tucker, Rebecca Warren, Richard Lumen, Robert Krucha, Ron Baden, Sergeant John McNamara, Specialist Kyle J. Swanson, Terry Vorderer, Tony Smith, Victor Juarez, Walter Kimmick, William Stalker, Paul Yeager, and Glenn Zach.
Thank you, Calvin and Evelyn. Again, never easy to come up and take the mic, especially when you have to. 15 years. It doesn't seem like a long time to me, but when I look around the room and I recognize that most of the people in the room have not been alive as long as I've been serving in Oak Lawn, it kind of changes my perspective a little bit. But it's been a great, great time serving here in Oak Lawn. Before I joined the Oak Lawn Police Department, I served 5 years in the Marine Corps, and I was a sergeant there. And while in the Marine Corps, I deployed twice to war, and I was fortunate to travel all around the world to some amazing places, including Japan, Italy, Germany, Ireland. The experience was just incredible. As the mayor said, there's things that you do in the military that I don't know that you can really do anywhere else. At least I know that I could. But those experiences, they taught me many things. And some of the most important lessons that I learned, they came from the mentors who guided me during that journey. And so I wanted to just talk about a couple of the lessons that I learned from those mentors along the way. And the first lesson that I learned was to choose to do the hard right over the easy wrong. Our lives will present us with many choices, and it is tempting to take the easy route. But the right choice often requires courage. And when we continuously, consistently choose what's right, even when it's hard, we grow into people others can trust and respect. On my way over here today, I had left a piece of my equipment in my car, and I knew I was just coming here to give a speech and I'm going back to an office. And I was like, oh, I don't need that. I don't need it. But the truth is, I have no idea what's gonna happen today. And so I had to do the hard right or the easy wrong and go back to get that piece of equipment, because I know I was gonna talk to you guys about this today, and I couldn't be a hypocrite for one. But it's the right thing to do, right? So I did that. The second lesson is to take responsibility and seek responsibility for your actions, whether or not they're good or bad. In the Marine Corps and in law enforcement, I've learned that holding yourself accountable is a foundation of good character. We all make mistakes. Each and every one of us makes mistakes. But learning from them can make us stronger. And when we take responsibility, we show ourselves first, and then others, that we are ready to lead and have integrity. And the final lesson is to hope for the best, but prepare for the worst. This is a mindset I carry with me each and every day. We all want things to go well, and many times they do. But we also need to be ready for life's challenges and the problems that come along with it. By preparing for difficulty and building the skills to handle them, we're better equipped to face whatever comes our way with confidence and resilience. So these lessons show us that serving others and building a strong character aren't just for those of us in uniform. They're for everyone. You can start living by these values today, whether it's by helping a friend, standing up for what's right, or simply doing your very best each and every day. You don't have to wait to be older or have a certain job to make a difference. You can lead your school, among your friends, and in your community. And when I say that last line, it kind of comes to mind. We lost a Chicago police officer earlier this week on Monday. His name is Enrique Martinez, and he served his community. He did. And if you guys don't mind, I'd just like to take a brief moment of silence for Officer Martinez. Thank you. So as we honor our veterans today, I hope you can learn something from these small lessons and make a commitment to serve others by choosing what's right, taking responsibility, and always being prepared to face challenges. I believe when we live these values, we'll be building a foundation for a future where you can all make a difference. And make no mistake, all of you are the future of our community. Thank you very much.
I'm not sure that it could have been said any better from one of Oak Lawn's finest, so thank you very much. Those are amazing words for the mayor. And I will say, had the great pleasure of working with at a training very recently. Sergeant Witt, and what you talk about and having your character and being prepared is absolutely what was seen in the opportunity that I had to work with you. So congrats to you for following through on exactly the words that you speak to this day. That's much appreciated. Please join us. Our OMS concert band, concert chorus, Summer of Singers are now going to be performing. We're going to perform Our America, arranged by John Higgins. We'll also be running at this time our OMS family and friends slideshow at the same time. So please enjoy some music and some pictures to commemorate our day. I just had to take the mic out and turn around because, again, we're talking about middle school students performing the way that they do, and I wanted to turn just so I could look at each of you and tell you thank you. In our school, we have about 1,100 total students, and about roughly 200 of them right now are helping us perform and put on this assembly. And these students that are all sitting up here very nervously today, getting ready, preparing, put in a ton of time. They put in a ton of effort. And this is a true testament to all of you for the hard work that we get to watch and listen to. You guys are amazing. Thank you very much.
Please rise as we welcome Doug Harmon, retired Lieutenant Colonel of the United States Air Force.
we'll get started in just a second.
Gratitude that our veterans have instilled in us, not only today. Thank you again, and may we continue to remember and honor the sacrifices of our veterans. Veterans, community members, and guests, we can ask you to kindly stay seated until we can dismiss our scholars back to their grade level floors. Scholars, please wait for your teacher's name to be called. Teachers, you're going to escort your students to their grade level floor. 6A, 6B, when your name is called.